Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the .NET MAUI ListView control. You will see how to tailor the items using templates, as well as how to apply alternate row styling. You will also see how to enable swiping and customize them using templates and header, footer, and item size customization. Finally, you will see how to customize the item's layout. I will be continuing with an existing MAUI application that has the necessary namespace and added list view control with data. If you want to know how to add the .NET MAUI list view to an app with simple list data, watch the Getting Started video linked in the card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description below. Now, I'll run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the list view displays data for all the contacts based on the assigned data source, which is specified through the item template. First, let's see how to customize list view items using different templates. For example, if I want to highlight missed calls in the list, I create a new class named Contact Info Selector. Make this class public and inherits from the Data Template Selector class. Then, I define two data template properties called Normal Template and Missed Call Template. Next, I create a new variable called Contact to retrieve contact details from items in the OnSelectTemplate method. Then, I check if it was a missed call. If it was, it returns the missed call template. Otherwise, it returns the normal template. To assign templates, I navigate to the main page XAML. Let me create two templates inside the content page resources. For the normal template, I use the existing item template. And set its key to normal template. Similarly, for the missed call template, I use the existing template, but set its contact number's text color to red, and its key to missed call template. I declare the Contact Info Selector class with a key, and assign the defined templates to the normal template and missed call template. Next, I comment the item template section and define the item template property, setting its value to the template selector. Notice here, the list view displays missed called mobile numbers in red, while other numbers are shown in black color. Following that, I will show you how to position items horizontally. To do this, I define the orientation property and set its value to horizontal. Before running the example, revert the previous code changes. And modify the grid column definition to a row definition in the item template to display the contacts' names and numbers below the image. You can see that all the items are arranged horizontally. Next, let me proceed to show you how to customize the item size and spacing. Before that, I will revert previous code changes. And load contacts' names and numbers only. You can see that the list view displays the names and numbers alone. By default, the item size is 48 and the spacing between each item is 0. To change these two values, let me define item size and item spacing properties with appropriate value. I have set item size as 70. And item spacing as 10. you will observe that the item size and spacing between each item are customized. To apply alternate row styling for items, I create a new class called IndexToColorConverter. Once the class is created, let me make this class public and inherit the iValueConverter interface. In the convert method, retrieve the ListView instance from the parameter and get the display index of the item in the ListView. Then, check if the index is even. If it is, return the items in light gray color. Otherwise, return aquamarine. Next, go to the main page XAML file and add the IndexToColorConverter class to the page resources with a key. Then, define the background property within the grid panel inside the item template and set its value by binding the converter to the IndexToColorConverter. Finally, set the converter parameter property to a reference of the ListView control. Notice here, the alternate rows are customized in the ListView. For more information on customizing the appearance of a ListView, please refer to the documentation link provided in the video description. Now I'm going to change the ListView data source to explain the customization of item size, swiping, header and footer features. To do this, I have already bound the product info class, which contains information such as products names and description, and generated product details in the product info repo class. I change the binding context to product info repo and item source to products. Then, modify the item template and adjust the item size accordingly. Additionally, remove the item spacing property. As you can see, the list view displays data of all the products in a clear and concise manner. Next, let me show you how to enable swiping and perform a custom action, deleting data. To enable swiping, I set the allow swiping property to true. The swiping UI can be customized by using swipe templates, such as the start swipe template to swipe towards the right, and the end swipe template to swipe towards the left. First, I define the start swipe template and add a data template with an image to customize the UI. Similarly, define the end swipe template. I have used same code with different image. Notice here, the list view displays swipe templates when swiping. If you want to delete an item from the view while swiping, define the swipe ended event and navigate to the event handler method. Here, check if the swipe offset value is greater than or equal to 100. If it is, remove the swiped item from the products collection using the index of the list view item. Notice here, the swiped item being deleted from the view. If you want to learn more about the list view swiping, please refer to the documentation link provided in the video description. Next, let me show you how to customize the appearance of the header and footer. Before starting, remove the swiping code changes. To set the header, define the header template property with data template. In this template, I will add the grid panel with a label. Set its background color to light gray. Then, set the label text to products, font size to 24, font attributes to bold, and horizontal text alignment to center. Similarly, to set the footer, define the footer template property with data template. In this template, I will add two buttons inside the stack layout. Set its orientation to horizontal. Then, set the first button's text to edit and second button text to delete. Also add these properties to customize it. Now, you can see the list view with a header and footer. However, as you scroll the page, the header and footer within the list view become hidden from view. Suppose, I want to stick in the view, simple set the isStickyHeader and isStickyFooter properties to true. You will notice that the header will stick to the top, and the footer to the bottom of the view when scrolling through the list. By default, the header and footer size are 40. In case I want to change the size, then set the header size and footer size properties to 60. You will observe that the size of the header and footer has been updated accordingly. Next, let's see how to customize the item size. To adjust the size of items based on the content loaded in the item template, define the AutoFit Mode property and set its value to height. Notice here, the list view automatically adjusts the size of each item based on its content, ensuring that everything is visible and easy to read. If you want to customize the item size of a particular column on demand, define the Query Item Size event and remove the AutoFit Mode property. Navigate to this event handler method. Here, you can check the item index value and return a custom size for that item. For example, to change the size of the second item, check if the item index value is equal to 1. If it is, set item size to 150 and handle to true. You can see that the size of second item is customized in the list view. Next, let's see how to customize the item layout. Before that, remove the Query Item Size event in the main page XAML. The list view control provides two different layouts, linear and grid. The linear layout is the default layout, which arranges the items in a single column vertically or a single row horizontally. However, if you want to arrange items in a predefined number of columns, define the items layout property and set its value to grid layout. To specify the number of columns, set the span count property to 2. You can see that the items are now arranged in two columns. In this video, I have shown how to apply different templates for items and how to apply alternate row styling. I also showed you how to enable swiping and customize the swipe templates, header, footer, and item size customization, and how to arrange items in different layouts. If you want to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.